Hello everybody, today we will discuss the concept of the discrete time signal, that is how, what is the properties of the discrete time signal, how the discrete time signals will be presented and what are the different types of the operations that will be operated on the discrete time signal system, discrete time signals, and we will also discuss how these discrete time signals will be utilized for the generation of the new complex signals here that may be considered as the model of the signals for the purpose of the testing of any design algorithm or the system. So here if we consider the concept of the signal, then as we know the signals are described as, if we say here what is the signal, then signal itself is nothing but the signal is said to be the physical variable or any physical quantity that changes with respect to any one variable or more than one variable. And for simplicity, suppose we consider here any voltage or the current that is changing with respect to time, then generally we write it like the f of the t. And what is the meaning of this one? It means now this function is existing for each and every time here. And practically this can be represented something like in this manner, that suppose we consider here the signal and that is represented here something like in this manner, that is a function that is changing its value with respect to here, that say this is the axis that represents the time and this represents here the amplitude here. So we can say this is a graph that representing the value of the amplitude here. That changes with respect to a variable, that is the t here, and it exists for each and every value of the t, and it is also known as the continuous time signal here. Now if we select only here the discrete version of this sequence here, or we can say this is a function and we are interested in order to select only the discrete values of this signal here, that is say if we consider here the values like the here the only these points here, that is this is the point here that is the selected for the purpose of the selection here, this is the next point, this is the next point and so on here, that is we are selecting only the discrete values in order in place of the selecting here the total values of the time, then this function may be represented something like in this manner, that is this is the value that is at this point, this is the value that is point here and so on. Now see, here we are selecting only the sum values in place of the total time. Now we have selected here the sum selected time here, and for those time we have considered the amplitude, and now this function may again be represented something like in this manner, that is the function is same but we have selected the function for the discrete time, that is the here the ft. The function is the ft, but here the condition is in place of the t. Now we have considered only the here the say any integer is the k and k times capital T. That is the capital T is this duration here, that we are selecting the signal for this duration and for the same duration we are rejecting the signal. So this can be also represented something like in this manner, that is the f of the kt, or generally we write this function like the f of the k, and it is named as the discrete time signal here. So here in place of the selecting the total signal here, we are selecting here only the samples of the signal for the different time interval, and for the same time interval we are rejecting here the signal, and this is named as the discrete time signal. So what is the advantage of this one? For this duration we are processing the signal, and for the next duration we have the space here, so for that duration we can process the another signal here. So the multiplexing can be adopted here for the purpose of the processing in order to make a more efficient any system here. But presently we will discuss only the different types of the discrete time signal here, and first of all we will discuss what is the different type of the representation of any discrete time signal here. Suppose we are interested to represent any signal and say the signal representation, here the representation of any signal. Representation of any discrete time signal. There are other different methods by which we can represent the signal. First is the, here we consider the first representation is the graphical representation here. The graphical representation. In the graphical representation, here the signal will be represented in the form of the graph here. For example, say we have any signal f of the k or the x of the k, or in general we use here the, sometimes we use the function the x of the n or the x of the f of the n. So suppose we consider here the function xn, and xn exists for the different values of the n here. So graphically we can represent this function something like in this manner, that is this is the axis that represents the different values of the n. Suppose this is the n equal to 0 and this is the n equal to 1, this is the 2, 3 and so on. And similarly here, say the left side minus of the 1, minus of the 2, minus of the 3 and so on. And say if this value has the 1, this is the value, having the value of the 1, and say this is the 2. This is the 1, this is the 2, and say this one is 3 here, and say this is the 0 here, and suppose this is the again 1, this is 1, this is 0, and say this is the 2 here. So these are the values which are represented here graphically. This is the graphical representation of any discrete time signal here. And these are on the x axis, we are representing the different values of the n here. And the second one is the, here the functional representation. In the functional representation, we represent the values of the discrete time signal in terms of the function. For example, if we consider here any function x of the n, the x of n is a function, the value of the x n is represented here for the different values of the n here. Say it has the value of the, for example it is the 1 when n is equal to 0, and this is 2 when n is equal to 1, and it is 3 when n is equal to 2 and so on. Similarly we can write this one as the 1 when n is equal to minus of the 1, and it is 0 for the n equal to minus of the 2 and so on. This is the way by which we can represent the same function or the same discrete time signal. Again we can write this one something like this. Suppose there is a new function and it is represented something like in this manner, that is the 2 to power n u n. This is also the functional representation, or we can also represent this one like the x n is equal to here the 2 to power n when n is greater or equal to the 0. So these are the way by which we can represent that any function in the functional way here. Now the next method is, that is the basic, the first representation is the graphical, and the second one is here the functional representation, and the third one is, say the third method is the tabular method here. And the tabular method, here the values of the, that is the amplitudes will be represented for the different values of the n here in a form of the n here. So here we can write the different values of the n, and for those values we can write here the amplitude here, that is the x of the n will be represented here. So if we consider here the values like the 0, 1, 2, 3, 1, and similarly here we can consider minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and so on here, and corresponding value of the x n here the for the 0, this is the 1, 2 and this is the 3 and this is the 0 and so on, and similarly for the negative values of the n, that is the minus 1, it is the 1, it is the 0 and this is the here the 2. This is the another way of the representation of the discrete time signal here. Now the fourth method is the sequential representation, that is the representation of the function using the sequence representation here. In the sequence representation, we use the curly bracket. Sequence representation. In sequence representation, we use the curly bracket. For example, here we can write the x n, the values, and what are the values here? These values are the 2, comma, then 0, then minus 1, then sorry, not minus 1, but it is the 1 and again 1. Here the minus, this is the 2, 0, 1, 1 and the 2. 3 and 0 and so on. Now, in order to represent here the 0, that is what will be the location and position of the 0 here for the n equal to 0, we use here the one arrow here. This arrow will represent the value of the n is equal to 0. So, for the n equal to 0, it is 1, for 1, it is the 2, 3 and so on. So here we can say we have discussed here the four methods for the purpose of the representation of any signal, and these methods are the graphical representation, functional representation, third one is the tabular, and the fourth one is the sequence representation here. Now if we represent here the, now we are, suppose we are interested in order to describe here the sum and product of the sequence here. That is how the sum and the product of any sequence will be represented here. Sum and product. And product. Suppose we have that two sequences, and these are the same. We have that one sequence is that AN, and the second one is the BN. Then, and we are interested in order to add these two sequences, then we will get here the third sequence and say the third sequence is the C of the N. So, C of the N will be generated by adding the element of the AN to the corresponding element of the BN here. Or we can say here this implies that here the CN will be equal to the AN plus BN, but the AN and the BN are the elements here. Similarly, if we are interested in order to generate say a new function, that is the PN, that is the product of the two functions are the two sequences, then and these sequences are the AN and the BN, then we will get here the this sequence PN by the product of the elements of the AN and the BN. Next we will describe here the elementary discrete type of the signal here, or we can say the basics discrete time signal, the elementary discrete time signal are the basic discrete time signal. Here the basic discrete time signals are the standard discrete time signal will be utilized in order to represent the complex discrete time signal. We can say we are interested in order to develop any physical model of the real time signal that has to be represented in the discrete time signal, then the basic building block of that signal will be the elementary discrete time signal here. And these elementary discrete time signals are the first one is the unit step sequence here. The unit step sequence. Here the unit step sequence is nothing but in this one we have to consider the unit step sequence is represented something like in this manner, that is the Un. That is the Un is equal to, it exists only when n is equal to greater or equal to the 0, and this value, if this is value is the 1, then it is named as the unit step function here. That is, this is 1 only when the n is greater or equal to the 0, and this is 0 otherwise. Then this type of the representation will be known as the unit step sequence here. And graphically, this can be represented something like in this manner, that is the, here the function exists only for n equal to 0. And this value is equal to 1. And for the negative values, it will become here, say, and for the n equal to 0, it exists here. And for the negative value, that is the n equal to minus 1 and minus 2, say this value is equal to the 0, 0, 0 and so on. This is for the minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. It is, this value is 0, 0. And for these values here, that is the for 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on, this will be equal to the 1 here. The same value, that is the 1, 1, 1, 1. This will be, this will exist here. And so on. This is also the 1 here. For this value here. That is when n is equal to 0. So the function has the value of the 1 only when n is 0 or its value is 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. So this will be represented as the Un, unit step sequence here. The second one is named as the unit impulse sequence. Unit impulse sequence is represented as the del of the n, and it exists only when that n is equal to 0 and its value is 1. Otherwise it is the 0. So now if we are interested in order to represent this one, then this can be represented something like in this manner, that is say this is a axis here, and this is the value for the n equal to 0 and 1, 2, 3 and 4 and so on. And similarly here, say the minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and so on. And it is just only for this value. That is when n equal to 0, this value is equal to the 1 here. And this is represented as the del of the n. And for other values, it is equal to the 0. Now, if we are interested in order to make a relation between the unit step sequence and unit step impulse function or the sequence, then we can say, if this is a function here, and if we are interested to shift this one here towards the right side, then this can be again represented here something like in this manner, that is the, whatever is the, was the sequence here, in this case, suppose we are interested to shift it, something like in this manner, that this is shifted by 1 by 2 here, that is the, whatever is the since we have shifted this one towards the right side, so it will start from here, that is n equal to 0, and now it will start from the n equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, and like that here. Now see here. Since it is just for the infinite values of the n, and we have shifted it towards the right side by one amount here. Now if this is the un, then it has been shifted towards the right side, and shifting is represented by the n minus k. That is, it has, it may be, now this will be represented as the un minus 1. That is, the there is a delay of the 1 unit, and it has been shifted towards the right side. Now if we consider a difference of this function and this function, then all the terms are same here except this one. So we will get here, that is that if we subtract the un minus 1 from the un, then we will get this function here, that is the del n. That is the, here the del n is nothing, but we can say this is, here the del n is nothing, but this is that un minus of the un minus 1. Similarly, if we are interested in order to represent the UL, that is the unit step function, in terms of the del L, then how it will be represented here? For the presentation of the UL, now if we see, then we will find this is the del of the N. If we accept all other terms here, and we consider only this one here, only this one, this will be represented as the del of the N. And if we consider this section here, this one, then this will be represented as the del n when it has been shifted by one amount, so del n minus 1, and so on. Similarly, this will be represented as the del n minus 2, like that here. So we can say here the total un function can be represented something like in this manner, that is, it is nothing but the un is equal to, that is, the un is del n plus del n minus 1 plus del n minus 2 and so on. Now this can be also written as something like in this manner, that is, that it is nothing but the summation of the del n minus k, where k exists from 0 to say some value of the n here. So we can say that un is nothing but the un is represented as in terms of the del n, or the impulse function, we can write this one as the summation of, this is the summation of del n minus k when k exists from 0 to value of the n. So this is your, these are the relation between the un and the del n, that is, the del n can be represented by this relation here, and similarly we can represent here the un. Now the next sequence that can be represented is the, that is, the third one. Here the third one is the unit rank sequence. Why we are calling here the unit? Because in this case we have considered here the amplitude as equal to the 1. That is, this value is the maximum 1. That's why we call it as the unit step sequence, the total. And each and every sequence will be represented as the impulse, that is, the having the value of the 1. Now if we compare this unit impulse function with the impulse function in the continuous time domain, then we will find that in the continuous time domain, the impulse function is represented by the del of the t, that exists at the t equal to 0, and it is at t equal to 0, it is the infinite. But here we are considering the function at n equal to 0, and the value of the, that is, the amplitude is the maximum amplitude is the 1, that is the finite one. It is the finite value here. But in the case of the continuum, we are getting the infinite. So this is the beauty of this impulse sequence here. Now if we consider the unit ramp sequence, the unit ramp sequence is represented by here the Rn is nothing but this is presented as the M U N. That is just for the M when N is greater or equal to 0 here. For the first value of the N here. Now this can be represented something like in this manner. That is the X when this is equal to the 0, then it becomes a this becomes here for n equal to 0, it is equal to the something like in this manner, that is the this can be represented like here the sine function of the n. That is say we have any function S n is equal to A sine omega n, that is the n is interior, omega n plus phi, where the A is the amplitude, this one is the amplitude here. And this is the angular frequency here. And this is the integer, any integer value. And phi is the phase. Now, if we here we can look at the omega, omega is nothing but this is equal to that 2 pi by n is the omega here, that is the fundamental angular frequency here. Or we can say if we are interested to represent the omega, this may be also multiplied by the sum value of the n here. So if we see, then we will find any continuous time signal is always set to the periodic, but it is not true in the case of the discrete time signal here, because the discrete time signal will be periodic only when the omega is the rational multiplication of the 2 pi. Only then this can be considered as the periodic function. Now this function can be represented something like in this manner, that is the say this is the any continuous value here. So the continuous value can be represented something like in this manner, that is the sinusoidal signal is something like in this manner. This is the sinusoidal signal, and for each and every value of the t here. But if we are interested in order to represent this one with a, and in this case particularly in this case the phi is 0 here, and if we are interested to represent here the discrete time signal, then we have to consider the discrete points here, like the this one here, the discrete point, that is the discrete points will become here this one. Points are the discrete values at the discrete time intervals will be selected here, and hence we can represent this one in the graphical way. Or more specifically, we can represent something like in this manner. That represents the amplitude here. We are drawing the vertical lines in order to show the amplitude of the signal which have been considered here for the discrete values of the time here. That is, we have selected here the discrete values in place of the considering the total values here of the signal. Similarly, we can consider here that this one. Similarly, we can consider here towards the negative side, negative values of the n. So, in place of the considering the total values, now we are considering the discrete
values of the time. Discrete multiples of the in, that is the integer multiple of the time, yeah. And now these values will be represented by the time. This is the sinusoidal representation here. And similarly, we can consider here the real time exponential function here. The real exponential sequences. And these real time, exponential sequences may be represented something like in this manner, that is that say the x of n is equal to a to the power of n, and say we consider here the a to the power n only. And if we multiply this one by the a to the power n u n, then this will become here the value of the xn that will exist only for the n when it is the 0 or the positive. But this time this is the for all values of the n. Now if we consider here the different cases here, say we consider here the when a is greater than 1. If a is greater than 1 and we consider here the sequence something like in this manner, that is this is the value when n equal to 0. At n equal to 0 this will become here the 1. When n is greater than 1, that is, since a is greater than 1, when n is greater than 1, it will be larger values exponentially increasing here, something like in this manner here, and so on. And if it is negative, so here this will decrease here, something like in this manner. So this is the value for the minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. This is the graphical representation when a is greater than 1 here. Now if a is less than 1, when the a is less than 1, in that case what will happen? If the a is less than 1, then the value will decrease something like in this manner, that is at the n equal to 0. Here this value will be equal to the say 1, and before this one larger than 1, something like in this manner. So this is the way, and as we are increasing the value here, this decreases something like in this manner. So on. That is the exponentially increasing here, something like this. And in this case, it is exponentially increasing. Now if a lies between the 0 and 1, that is the a is less or equal to the 0, that is between the 0 and 1, then what will happen in this case, that is that if a lies between the 0 and 1, and suppose not the 0 and 1, but if it is lying between the 0 and 1, then actually this will be greater than 0 here. Now if a is less than 1, when a is less than 1, then what will happen? Here this is the case when we have considered that a lying between the 0 and 1. Now if the a is less than 1, then for this case, that is the point a is less than 1, the value will be increasing here, but in alternate manner. That is the here the for the a equal to 0 or the less than the 0, the values will be smaller here. This is the smaller value, next one, higher value, next one. In alternate, with the alternate sign, here the value is increasing. Something like this. That is when the a is less than 1. So in this one we have rejected the two more graphs, that is the sinusoidal sequence and the real exponential sequences here. Now we can represent here the some complex exponential sequence. Here the suppose we consider here the complex
sequential, complex sequential, complex sequential. Then that in the complex exponential sequences, we can consider here that this is a complex exponent. And say we consider here that xm is equal to a and its power is the n, and say it is multiplied by the j omega naught. That is that here the this is the omega naught plus phi. Say some phi with the phase. In this case, we can write this one as that a n cos omega naught multiplied by say n multiplied by n plus phi plus j sine omega naught n multiplied by omega naught n plus phi. Now there may be the different conditions for a is equal to 0, the real and imaginary, sorry, a when n is equal to 1 or the when, sorry, a is equal to 1. If the a is equal to 1, for that case, the real and imaginary portions both will be the here the sinusoidal. And if a is greater than 1, then sinusoidal sequence exponentially grows. When the a is equal to 1, then this will be the sinusoidal. Sinusoidal function. And both will be the sinusoidal. Real and the imaginary portion here. If a is greater than 1, then the function will exponentially increase here. That is just say this is the function here. And this will exponentially increase here, something like in this manner. Positive at the negative side. And the nature will be the sinusoidal. Exponentially increasing here when a is greater than 1, and when a is less than 1, this will be exponentially decreasing function here. Now we will discuss here some basic operations. Here the basic operations on discrete time sequences. In this discussion, we will consider here the time shifting. First, the time shifting. If we consider any function, say the x of the t or the x of the n is any function. Now, this may be related as the x n minus k or the x plus of the k. If we consider the x n minus k, it means here the and k is positive. Then at that time we can say this is the delaying in the function. If we consider here the x n minus k and k is greater than 0, that is the positive, then this is the delay. This represents here the delay of the sequence. Similarly, if we consider here the x n plus k and k is again positive here, then this is the advancement of the signal here. Now suppose we consider any example of the sequence and say any sequence is given something like in this manner, that is that we will use n equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, and say minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and so on, and say this is the value of the state, this is the 3, this is the 2, this is the 1, and say this is again 1. Similarly, you say this is the 1, this is the 0, and this is the 1. And this is the function x of the n. And we are interested in order to find the function x n minus k, or the sequence x n minus k. Then here it means the total function will be shifted by towards the right side by the k unit. And suppose we are interested in order to get the x n minus k. So the how the x n minus p will be represented? In order to get the x n minus p, we will represent this one here, something like in this manner. That is the starting point is the here the this is the say we consider this one, something like in this manner. That is the 0 here. This is the 0. 1. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and so on. So it has been shifted by the k unit towards the right side. So whatever is the value at n equal to 0, now the same will be at n equal to 3 here. So at n equal to 3, this will be the equal to the 3. And then another value is here, that is the 4, 4, 5, 6, and so on. At the 4, this will become here the 2, and this is equal to 1 and 1. And whatever was the minus 10, now this will be the 1 here, this will be the 0, again 1, and suppose another value are 0, 0 here. So whatever was the function, now it has been shifted by the units. Whatever was the value, it has been shifted by the units towards the right side. And this represents here the x n minus p. And the first one represents here the x n. So similarly, if we are interested in order to get the x n plus 3, then in x plus 3 or say the what will happen? This will shift towards the right side. And how this will be represented here? Now see the representation of the x n plus 3. So what if this is the n equal to 0? 1, 2, 3, and so on. So here the minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, and so on. So whatever is the value at x, n is equal to 0. This will be shifted towards at the x, n minus 3 here. So this will be the value here. Suppose we consider here the in new color, something like this manner here. And in order to represent this one, say this is the x n is equal to minus 3, this will become here the 3 here. This is the 3, 2, 1, and 1. Now another values like that 1. Has been shifted, that is the 1, 1, and this was the 1, 0, 1, this was 1, and 1, this was 0, 0. Now it has been shifted here towards the right side, that is the x n plus 3 here, in comparison with the x n function here. That is, when we write that x n plus 3, this will shift towards the right side, that is the advancement, and the minus, that will be the delay in the function. Now we can represent the another operation that is the we have to say b we are interested in order to get the time reversal.
The time reversal say there is a function and this function is the x of the n. Then x of the n, and if we replace the n by the, if the n is replaced by minus n or the minus n is replaced by the n, then it is known as the time reversal. That is the, we have reversed in the time domain here, and it is also known as the time holding, time reversal or the time holding. So if we consider here any sequence, something like in this manner, say this is the n equal to 0, minus 1, plus 1, minus 2, plus 2, minus 3, plus 3. Say it is at the n equal to 0, it is 1, 2, 3, say at the 2, which is equal to the 3 here. And say this is the 4, and this is the representation of the x n. And when we write the x of the minus n, then this can be represented something like in this manner, that is the x n equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. And reversal of this one, that is the, this, now this will become the reflection, mirror image. That is the n equal to 0. This will remain same. That is the reversal about the vertical axis. Here the n equal to 0 and this is value 1. This was 1, 2, 3 and 4. So 1, 2, this will become here the 3 and this will become here the 4. So this is the representation of the x of the minus of the n here. And it is named as the time reversal. So we have discussed here the time reversal, time shifting, and now we will come to the next point, that is the amplitude scaling here. Amplitude scaling. Now suppose there is any function xn and we are interested in order to scale up or the scale down, that is the scaling is applied on the function. Then after scaling we will get a new function, that is the a times of the xn. This will become here the multiplied by a xn. If the a is greater than 1, naturally you will get here the higher amplitude, and if a is less than 1, then you will get here the amplitude less than 1. When a is greater than 1, at that time this is known as the amplification, and when a is less than 1, it becomes the attenuation. So if a is greater than 1, it becomes here the amplification. Since the amplitude is taking place, amplification. And if the a is less than 1, then at that time this will be known as the attenuation. After amplitude scaling, we will consider the next one, that is the, here we have to consider the time scaling. Here we have considered time reversal, amplitude scaling, next is the time scaling. Very important property of the operation of, that is applied on the signal, time scaling. Now suppose we have any function x of the n and we are interested in order to scale in terms of the time, then a n will be multiplied by a factor of the a here. And this, after scaling we will get here the new function, that is the x a n. And if a is greater than 1, here the a is greater
compression takes place here. Compression takes place here. And if A is less than 1, then expansion takes place here. For example, if we consider any signal, say the Xn is represented something like in this manner, that is the, this is represented as the, here the 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 0, 1, like that. This is the sequence here. And in this sequence, we have not represented what is the location and position of the n is equal to 0. And if in any finite duration sequence representation, there is no representation of the 0, that is the n is not represented here for what is the location and position of the n equal to 0, then the first term is considered as the initial, that is the initial point is considered as at n equal to 0 here. So this will be the n equal to 0. And now if we consider here the n equal to 0 and we will draw the graph, the n equal to 0, this is the n equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that. At n equal to 0, it is 1, 2, it is 3, it is 4, then again it is equal to 1, and this is the 0. This is the sequence here. And it is the graphical representation of the xn. This is the, here the sequential representation of the xn. Now if we are interested in order to say, get here the x of the 2n, then how the x of the 2n will be calculated? When n is equal to 0, n equal to 0, x of the 2n, that is the, this will become here the x of the 0. When n equal to 1, now we have to find the n equal to 1, so we have to represent the x of the, x of the 0, that is the 1 here, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 1 and 0. And for n equal to 1, this will become the x of the 2, x of the 2, that is the 3 here. When n equal to 2, at that time this will become here the x of the 4, x of the 4, that is equal to 1 here. And now suppose the n equal to 3, and n equal to 3, that is the x of the 6, and suppose the x of the 6 is again 0 here, so here say that 0, then we will get here the 0. Now if we are interested in order to draw the graph, then we will find the graph something like in this manner here, that is the, this is the n equal to 0, and the next is the n equal to 1, 2, and the 3. At n equal to 0, the value is equal to the 1, so this is the 1. At 2, 1 equal to 1, this will become the x of the 2, that is the 3. This value becomes here the 3. And 2, this will become the x of the 4, that is the 1. And at the 3, this will become the 0. Now if we will see, then we will find this is the representation of the x of the 2n. So what is happening in this case? This is the xn and this is the x of the 2n. In this one, when we have represented the 2n, that is the x of the an, when a is greater than 1, the sequence has been compressed. Or we can say, in this case, we are discarding this sequence here. The x at 1, 3 and 5. These have been discarded here. Or we can say, these have been here the discarded, which sequences? The odd sequences have been discarded here. So when the n x 2n, and means a is greater than a, 1, a is greater than 1, then at that time the compression takes place here. Similarly, if we are interested in order to get here the x of the 1 by 2n, then how the x of the 2n will be calculated? When n equal to 0, this will become here the x of the 0, that is equal to the 1 here. When at n equal to 1,
1, then they become a half of this one, or the n equal to 2, this will become here the x of the 1, that is, this will become here the x of the n equal to 2, n equal to x of the 1, x of the 1, that is, this will become here the 2 here, and there is one more term, and similarly here the n equal to 4, then we will get the x of the 2, x of the 2, that is the 3 here, and one more term here for the n equal to 3, and n equal to 6, then we will get here the x of the 3, and x of the 3 equal to 4, and x of the 8, then we will get here the x of the 4, that is x of the 4 will become here the 1 like that. Now if we are interested in order to draw the graph, then find the graph are plotted here for the values of the n equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and similarly minus 1, minus 2, like that here. So the graph at the n equal to 0, this is 1. At 1, this is 2, 3, this is here the when x equal to 4, this will come the 2, that is the 3, and this one is the next x equal here, this is the 2, x 1, 2, and 4, then this will come at the 4, this will come the x of the 2, x of the 2 equal to 3 here, this is the 2, 1, 2, and we are going to get the 3, and 6, when the n equal to 6, this will become the x of the 3. Again we are trying this one. Say n equal to 0, start from here, n equal to 0, x of the 0, now this will become the 1, 1, x of the 1, x of the 1, this will become the 2, x of the 2, it becomes the 3, x of the 4, x of the 3, it becomes the 4, and x of the 4, it becomes 1. And in between, for the odd values, there will be the sequences here. So, what is happening? In this one, there are more sequences in between the two sequences here. That is the compression is taking place. When n is, expansion is taking place. When n is less than 1, the expansion is taking place here. But when a is greater than 1, the compression takes place here. Now, we will come to the another operations here, like the we have discussed here the time scaling and the time reversal amplitude scaling. Some more operations that are operated on the signals are the addition and multiplication. If we are interested in order to add the two sequences or the two signals, for example this is a sequence and we consider the another sequence, that when we are trying to add or subtract the two sequences, then element wise operation takes place, means the positional elements will be either added or the subtracted. Similarly, if we are interested for the multiplication and the division, then during the time of the multiplication and the division, element wise operation takes place here. That is the elemental operation will take place here. That is the element at the corresponding location and position will be either added or the subtracted here. So we have discussed in this one, if we see, then what we have discussed from the starting, if we come to the previous slide, then we have discussed here the basic operation, and basic before the basic operations we have described here the different types of the representation of the sequences in this one, like here the sinusoidal, exponential, real time, and complex, say here the exponentials, and we have also represented here the sum product and different types of the sequences in this lecture here. And before this one, we have discussed here the different types of the representation of the signal here. So in this lecture, we have discussed what is the concept of the discrete time signal, and what are the different types of the representations, and what are the different types of the operations that can be performed on the discrete time signals here. In the next lecture, we will discuss some more operations on the discrete time signals, and we will also discuss here how these discrete time signals will be generated with the help of the MATLAB and the mathematical representations. Thank you very much.